Hey, Sports fans, Ribber here for Carnival Gaming. Now it's bonfire night here in the UK. I'm just gonna walk over to my window. You might be able to. You might be able to hear some of that going on outside there. Yeah, I think you'll be able to hear that. So it was I thought I'd open the old window, and so you can all sort of enjoy with me the delight of small children watching fireworks outside and the horrible screams they make at everyone over the age of 20 hates. Anyway, let's crack on and try not to suck in the arena so much. If I make a misplay because a big bang goes on outside, do you think they'll refund me my gold? Ooh, well, look at that. There's some more pally on offer. And I do have a pally daily. And given both Hunter and Warlock are super weak, I don't really think I have any alternative. A nice star, Sergeant Commander. Argent Commander's also a paladin, so themed. I don't think Angry Chicken is a paladin. The Abomination, of course, could have been a paladin in his former life. Two unplayable cards and a gnomish inventor. Certainly not the best 4-drop. Hammer of Wrath and Argent Protector, both fine. I prefer the Protector. That little bit faster. And definitely like Zombie Chow. Absolutely. It's a good card to play turn one, then put a Protector on it. I pretty much will always take Frostwolf Warlord when it's on offer. You know, certainly in a Pally deck, it could be like 5 mana for an 8-8. Super easy. So this is pretty good start here, because we're getting like one playable card and do pretty crap cards each time. Which is quite nice. The owl might be okay here, to be honest. You know, it can be decent to take a couple of things with silence. Yeti! I think probably the right thing to do here is take the Blessing of Wisdom, because you can cycle it, you know, you can just play it, attack with your guy, knowing your guy is going to die next turn, and draw a replacement card. But if it sticks on whatever you play for a couple of turns, then it just starts getting ridiculous. Like, even if it only draws one extra card, stuff's going on outside. Even if it only draws one extra card, that's the same as Arcane Intellect, because Arcane Intellect is like 3 mana, draw 2 cards, so you're up 1 card. So simply by drawing one extra card of Blessing of Wisdom for 1 mana, you're drawing 2 cards. So, for me, and at worst, it's 1 mana replace itself, so it hasn't really hurt you. So for me, it's a super easy pick, as is this older Peacekeeper. Wolf. Meh. Guardian of Kings. Yay! Quite like Guardian of Kings. A second Zombie Chow. That certainly fixes my early game. Like, I don't have to worry too much then about the 2 mana drops. This one's a bit harder. Chill Wind Yeti or Shattered Sun Cleric. It actually is a little bit tougher. Even Frost Elemental. I mean, they're all great cards here. I'm really tempted with the Shattered Sun Cleric, because going second, you can make like a turn one Zombie Chow, and then give it +1/+1 by using the coin, and you've got like a 3/4 that's going to chew whatever they play on turn two. And have a bit left over, right? Chill Wind Yeti, he's pretty awesome as well. I think it's important to get a good 3 drop there, so I'm going to go ahead with that. And this has got to be Spectral Knight, such a good card, you know, mages hate him. Sounds like one of those link bait articles that you see on Facebook, you know. 10 ways, Spectral Knight. Screws over mages. Click now for details. Meh, another Argent Protector. Okay, I think we can start with sort of a few of the heavier cards in the deck now, because we got our early game pretty good. Shield Master's a good start. Yay! It's like the first time in years I've seen a true silver champion. I forgot they existed. A second Shattered Sun Cleric or the Fen Creeper. It's quite close, that one, actually. It's quite close. Given I've got these two Shattered Sun Clerics, it actually kind of makes a little bit of sense to pick up the Bloodsail Raider. Because making a 3-4 on turn 3 is really, really good, because your opponent's making a lot of 3-3s. So we want a few heavier guys now, a few big cards, or equalities. Equalities are also fine. Always take equalities when they're on offer. So, you know, we're looking for the fatter stuff now to come along. And, of course, Cultmaster, which makes perfect sense for this aggressive kind of deck. You just get to fill your hand back up. Yep. Fen Creepers are cool. Spiteful Smiths are cool. Like, anything with 6 toughness, you know, that survives the Flame Strike, makes it a lot easier to play these cards. Some people would take the Flesh-Eating Ghoul here, given the sort of huge number of minions we've got. I think Grizzly's fine as well, though, however. This one's a little bit tougher, because obviously the Spellbreaker's very important, but we don't have anything really at 6 or 7 mana. An Archmage is maybe a good one to think of. I still do like my Silence, though. So the question is, whether we want 7 mana for a 5-6 or 7 mana for a 7-7. Sometimes, you know, being that little bit weak as a benefit, because it can't be big game hunted. And so we're basically trading off 6 health for 2 power and 1 life. And I think we go with the Dark Iron Dwarf here. Like, we've got plenty of cheaper cards. How lucky! It's my favourite card again! Those of you who've watched any of my constructed videos will know how much I love Hogger. Seems a solid deck. However, you know, even sometimes solid decks just can go 0-3. If you just come up against 3 better solid decks. Only the 1 true silver, I mean, you know. I was never going to get that many. 1 true silver, 1 consecrate. Uther versus Anduin. The game doesn't like me enough.
I will fight with honor.
I'm going to keep hold of the true silver. I think that's actually pretty important. Because I've only got 1. You know, it's one of my few sort of solid card advantage cards. And this is pretty good, you know. Turn 2, coin a Harvest Golem, give it +1. Like, seems fine. Oh, that's pretty annoying, actually. Hope he got the coin. Because, I mean, these are just, like, the goods right here. Really hoping he got my coin. So I'm thinking, like, Harvest Golem, that turn 3, True Silver turn 4, Spectral Knight turn 5, Argent Commander turn 6, everything pretty much. You know, curves out perfectly using all my mana every turn. You got the Harvest Golem. Now, this is interesting. I don't think we should be wasting the peacekeeper here.
We must cleanse the Sunwell.
Well, it's certainly okay to just go ahead and play the True Silver, really.
For justice!
I might get an opportunity to put my Blessing of Wisdom on and draw a couple of cards very soon. Well, there's the Swampoos. He's walked into Consecration here with me having 4 mana. I mean, seems a bit risky from his point of view. I'm going to try and draw my Consecration. Like... and throw down a guy that, you know, maybe he has to run everything in to kill. Seems fine. But I can make Spectral Knight, which he can't target with his hero ability.
Squire, attend me.
Ready, sir.
Well, I want to do 2 things here. The Argent Commander and put a bubble on the Argent Protector. So I think the Commander has to wait in this case. Oh, we could certainly beat this up, like, with both. Or we could make the Peacekeeper and turn the 4-4 into a 1-4. And that leaves us with 4 mana, so we could put the bubble on as well. And make a bunch of guys.
for duty.
Hope you're all enjoying the fireworks. We don't know over there? Thank you. So it makes sense just to make the 5-6 here. Get my life back up and just carry on churning out the little guys. And just put tons of pressure on him here. And if I draw my cult master, then woo! It's just game over at that point, right? Yeah, it doesn't really do anything at all, does it? You like taking 14 next turn. Pretty good turn, that.
Reporting for duty.
Now, I could just go for his face here, but I think it's absolutely fine to carry on beating these things up, really. I could maybe leave the Stormwind champion. But I do like, I think, getting it off the board, to be honest.
To battle! The battle! The frost will stand ready! To battle!
Vengeance!
The battle!
So if he wants to mind control this, he can't obviously mind spike that guy.
They'll never know what.
Get in there and fight, man.
And that's him dead.
You have best.
Yep, he's like, turns out 10-10 is pretty good. And that's why I take Frostwolf Warlord. So, you know, he wasn't that he had terrible cards, like, his guys were fine, he was just really slow. And, sometimes Shadow Form can backfire. You know, if your opponent's making just bigger guys than you are all the time, you don't really get to kill anything with the Shadow Form.
Uther versus Malfurion!
I must protect the one.
And again, I've got my one true silver champion, which I'm going to keep. And again, I'm going second. Arrgh. But that's fine. Going second is fine. with this kind of hand. It's like, yep, turn two, coin a guy out, turn three, give it plus one, turn four, make a true silver. Especially when the guy you're coining out is like a harvest golem. So you're going to end up with a replacement. So, like, if I was to coin out the Iron Fur Grizzly... Yeah, obviously now I draw a zombie gel. if I was to coin out the Iron Fur Grizzly, he can cast Wrath and just kill it for 2 mana. Whereas if he casts Wrath on this and kills it, there's a 2-1 that's replaced, and then I can give it plus 1 and keep it out of range of his shapeshift ability.
What does the future
so, you know, that's pretty important.
We must cleanse the Sunwell.
Likewise, that's another reason. Shattered Sun Cleric's just so good in that spot, because he thinks, yeah, I can trade off and I'm fine here. And you go, nope.
I must safeguard the land.
So he went with the silence, which is interesting.
For justice.
Push forward. Because if he just dealt it 2 damage, then I would have had a 2-1. Right? If he'd just gone deal it 2 damage, I'm left with the 2-1. Instead, he silences it, and I'm left with the 2-2. Eh? He didn't really think that one through. But I've got all the tempo here, and I'm going to be making like some big guys the next couple of turns as well. I think this 2-3 is there to somehow, how lucky, bait my true silver, so I guess we just leave that there, right?
Push forward.
Now, if he's got a swipe, he's absolutely going to play it this turn. There's no way he's not swiping here. Or start falling.
Squire, attend me.
Ready, sir.
But, you know, I'm feeling pretty confident. There is the swipe. Like, look at me, I'm so skillful. What's that? I'm just thinking about next turn. Okay, if he makes an Ironbark next turn, then obviously I don't want to throw my 5-6 out there, right? Because I'm going to have to equality, and then I'm probably going to have to hit it with my True Silver, and then silence my own Guardian of Kings. So maybe we just go with something like the Grizzly and a 1-1. And if he plays the Ironbark, then we can just equality and throw the 1-1 in. Or...
Reporting for duty. The Frost Wolves stand ready.
Or just make a 5-5, I guess. With the that'll be sort of. The 4-4, if I want to silence it. I mean, we could also just, like, silence his Ironbark and just run them in. Or maybe you'd. Maybe just do that. I mean. Save the equality? Well, not even do that, yeah. Just attack it. Like, that seems fine. Save the equality for, like, his next Ironbark. Might have been a better spot for the Frostwolf Warlord. It's tough to say, really. Hey, look, it's another swipe.
Death does not scare me.
Pretty sure we just equality here. Actually, we can equality, and someone pointed this out in the chat, actually, which is really cool. You can equality here, and then silence your own guy. And he goes back to 4-4. I get a free guy, which is, of course, my worst guy. Of course it's going to be the 2-2 that I get. Can't be my war golem. He's played multiple swipes already. So, and Ironbark, so maybe he's out of good cards at this point. No, of course it's his third swipe. Absolutely ridiculous.
This is my responsibility.
So, maybe we've run him out of swipes, finally. We've not seen any Druids of the Claw, so that's been a good thing. But we're going to keep this Spellbreaker in our hand for the next thing he does. Well, no, not anymore. Because, I was going to say, as soon as he makes something with Taunt.
Your magic shall not save me.
Just gonna kill him. Seems like a plan. So, like, his deck was pretty good. But our deck was also pretty good. And that makes me very happy that I took that silence over that other really good card. Trying to remember what it was. Was it the War Golem? It was something really good. It was like 5 or 6 or 7 mana, wasn't it?
Let the hunt begin.
I will fight with honor.
Probably should keep hold of the Grizzly here. Oh! First sign of consecration. But going first, like, I like the Bloodsail Raider, because your opponents can make stuff like Worgen Infiltrator turn 1, and if you make a 3-2, they get to trade off, but you make a 2-3, they don't get to trade off. Yeah, and they make a 2-2. You get to screw them over that way as well. Though it is a beast. So he might have shenanigans to go with his beast. Oh, but that's a beautiful draw. That's pretty much the best draw I could have hoped for there, Shattered Sun Cleric. So, as always with hunters, always focus on just keeping their beasts off the board.
We must cleanse the Sunwell.
So, awesome tempo shift for me there. Gee, you think that's an explosive trap? What do you reckon? Well, that's unfortunate for him. I'm sorry.
Push forward.
Because that was one of the other things. I was like, well, I don't care if it's snake trap either. As your board's going to vanish, mine's going to stay exactly as it was at the start of the turn. Ouch.
Thailand lover, push forward.
I should probably have put the Chillwind Yeti on the left-hand side in case he has the explosive shot. Because if he explosive shots this, I get left with a 3-1 instead of with a 3-2.
Tadingo!
But, you know, because I went first, I pretty much got control of the board, and it's going to be very, very hard to lose it from here. And there is an explosive. So he's just having to be defensive the entire time. And I've got a little IMB cowl for if he makes something big with taunt. You know, he's got 6 cards in his hand and he just can't play them fast enough. He just couldn't get into that game. Going second there, my hand was just really strong. And that's some of the problems. Like, when you go second, sometimes it's just impossible for you to win. When your opponent does things like that. There was no way into the game for him. I didn't give him a chance, and I drew pretty much exactly what I needed every turn, really. Although the fact that he coined out a 2-2 on like the first turn probably cost him the game right there. Like, a 2-2 is not what you want in that situation.
I will fight with honor.
So we're going second, and we got the same combo of Harvest Golem, Shattered Sun Cleric. So, you know, that's pretty good. Wow, and we got the Zombie Chow as well. This is a ridiculous hand. This is the perfect curve out here. Oh! So good! How lucky! This is an unbelievable hand. Just crazy good. Ha ha! He's such a traitor. I mean, we could just trade these off, I suppose, and make a Blood Sail Raider.
X marks the spot.
Because he's going to make like a 3-3 here, I would imagine. Makes a 1-1. Yeah, that's cool. So, if I put the Blessing of Wisdom on this guy, and BW is 1-1, if he makes a True Silver Champion, sure, my guy dies. If he makes the Consecrate, my guy dies unless I coin out the Shattered Sun Cleric to buff it up. So it's a question of, do I want to protect against Consecrate that badly? But I quite like the idea of him consecrating from here. So I think I'd rather play the Harvest Golem here. Like, that seems fine, leaving me with a 2-1. I don't want to make the Shattered Sun Cleric. I mean, I'm just making a 3-2 for no reason, so I could just make like a 1-1 here. And then turn it into a 3-2 the following turn.
For justice!
Battle! And it turns out you're not the only one who can have a weapon. I bet he's got an ooze for mine, though.
For the Lich King!
So we have two choices here. We can turn it into a 1-6. Or we can just deal with it with our True Silver Champion. Or, of course, we can make Argent Commander. Which seems, you know, pretty cool as well. It does set us up for Consecrate a little bit, but...
To Northrend! Victory!
So it's like, c'est la vie.
Follow the rules.
X marks the spot.
Reporting for duty.
So, Shattered Sun Cleric here, 3-2, beat up his 6-3. 1-2, beat up the 1-1. Weapon, beat up the 3-3.
We must cleanse the Sun Well.
For justice!
I'm basically trying to draw into my equality, which I feel like I really need at this point. So both of these do 3, so I kind of need to deal 2 to it with the other thing, right? I don't really have anything that can deal 2, so I'd have to make the zombie chow. The idea being he runs Assassin into my 3-5, I just finish it off with the chow.
Mm.
not on my watch.
Again, doesn't surprise me.
Reporting for duty.
How lucky!
Follow the rule.
The frost will stand ready.
Push forward.
Your magic shall not.
He'd really have liked to have spellbreakered his own guy, but unfortunately for him, he didn't have that luxury.
Reporting for duty.
We must cleanse the Sunwell.
For the
reporting for duty.
But, you know, this is like completely equal game, really. That might just tip the balance slightly in his favour. Oh, that's certainly quite a nice draw there for me. Yeah, it's just about, hopefully, drawing all our big guys now, really.
Mind if I roll knee?
Reporting for duty.
Pretty good.
They are bent to my plan.
Yep, that was about as good as it gets for cards off the top of the deck. Oh, I'm so good at this game, aren't I?
Reporting for duty.
And you know, you definitely have to keep every single guy off the board. You know, he's going to have stuff in his hand that gives buffs.
Reporting for duty.
You call that?
Such as that Dark Iron Dwarf. You just can't let him have them.
Reporting for duty.
I'm ready.
I'm not ready.
Reporting for duty.
Handle it.
Well, we can hit him for 12. We can do again. We can do this really cool thing where we equality, and then silence the war golem to turn it back to 7/7. But we can run this into this. It's novel, but like it doesn't really help us. I think we just do all the trade-offs and keep hold of the equality until next turn. Like, that makes the most sense, really, to be honest.
To battle!
Your magic shall not save me.
Reporting for duty.
Well played.
Thank you.
I've got a hit!
And now it's back to full health.
Reporting for duty.
Yeah, that's fairly conclusive.
Ready, sir.
Reporting for duty. The battle!
So we've got really similar decks in terms of strength, to be honest.
Reporting for duty.
His may be a little bit weaker than mine. He's been drawing a fair few fairy dragons and 3/2s there, and I was making sort of big guys. So I think that, like, when you're playing off the top of the deck, my deck's a bit heavier than his. He has a lot more 2-drops, so, which is good when he gets his Sword of Justice going. But yeah, I felt that game hinged entirely on that consecration I drew. So, yep. Just when he was getting rolling with all these guys buffed off the Sword of Justice. And now we start to hit mages. Like, you get to 4 wins, you'll be now playing mages. So, yeah. Not the best time to get the slow hand. Ah, the Spectral Knight, though. That'll help me out enormously.
Reporting for duty.
So we might just be sat here for a while and then play equality, really. Yep, sit here, play equality, consecration, and then say go. We can actually put the Blessing of Wisdom on the Mad Scientist, because he'll have to attack with it if he wants to get a secret.
I wonder.
Reporting for duty.
So it's bound to replace itself.
Death does not scare me.
I'm sorry. I think we can hold back, to be honest. With the equality, like, let him play more guys out and get a ton of value. And that's just a bonus, just wasting frost bolts on those guys.
I'll show them. I'll show them all!
Attack for 4, then Equality Consecrate?
I wonder.
Or Equality Consecrate, and then run this into the 2-1 he gets out of it?
Well played.
Yeah, of course, again, of course it's the Argent Protector. it's not going to be anything other than the Argent Protector I get from the Death Lord. Twice now, it's been Argent Protector both times. Absolutely fascinating stuff, isn't it? You may also have a mirror entity.
Well played.
The Frost Wolves stand ready.
So, this is probably a duplicate. Like, if a mage has been given two... Okay, nice draw. Two of those. It makes sense that he would, have a duplicate to go with it, to be honest.
Join or die! Or both.
But it's not a duplicate, so we are indeed in luck there. And no flame strikes either. And a few crap guys to play on the side there. So this has got to be like a counter spell, pretty much. Pretty tasty, but I think we have to run him out of a few cards first, right?
They all bend to my command!
I guess he gets a harvest golem at this point. Yeah, there's got to be a duplicate there. And to be honest, I think we just let him have it. I mean, do you want to give him a spellbreaker? Or a harvest golem.
Let me think.
I run my 4-6, he's going to copy it, and just play a couple of 4-4s the following turn. Okay, so he's got a counterspell and a spellbender, maybe a vaporize or an ice block.
Kane, speak to me.
So yeah, I don't think running Cogger into a vaporize is that smart. So I'll sit him on. Oh, okay.
We must cleanse
That's
the
nice
sunwell.
Of him. He just went, yeah, you know what? You're gonna play around that, aren't you? Well, I guess if it was like a spellbender and a counter spell, he's just lost. Cool. Yeah, so maybe that's why he conceded. He just went, you know what, that Hoggis is going to destroy me, and I don't have any fireballs or polymorphs or flame strikes. So that was very lucky for us that we came up against a mage without any flame strikes.
Uther versus Jaina.
Shankara, it's another mage.
I will fight with honor.
And we're going second, so coin out the Raider, then the Argent Protector. I think we keep the Cultmaster. I really feel we need that in this sort of this little aggressive start. You know, draw a couple of cards, hopefully, and fill our hand back up. Obviously, to top deck a Zombie Chow, I mean, that would be incredible, one of my two Zombie Chows, right now. And we'd hear more fireworks going off because of it.
What to do? What to do?
Yes, it's your turn. Thank you. So we're hoping he has a guy, as opposed to a Frostbolt in his hand. If he has a Frostbolt, I cry. If he makes a guy, I get very happy. Very happy. All he has to do is make a guy. Just make a guy. Make me happy, make a guy. Because then I get to Argent Protected at 2-3, bubble it up, beat up his guy. Next turn, Shattered Sun Cleric, one of my guys. Oh, That is fine. Yeah, that's absolutely fine.
Not on my watch.
Dylan, lover.
Tempted to still enrage you, and like, it's a 5-1, you know? But now he just has to ping the shield off my guy. It's pretty much all he can do. It really ruins his third turn. That's pretty good as well. Yeah, we could just put the Blessing of Wisdom on his guy, really. That might well hack him off.
I wonder.
Because he'll still want to run it into my 2-3, because he knows my 1-1 will beat it up otherwise. You know, assuming he's going to use something with his mana. He pretty much is resigned to having to ping the 1-1 I make every turn.
I'll put it on your head.
Yep, he didn't want to give me a card, so he just went and picked it up instead. Cult Master, draw two cards, then trade that off afterwards. Seems a bit crap, doesn't it?
Pass me the Arclight Spanner! Die, Landlord!
The battle!
But this is fine, because I've got Consecration in my hand, and this guy will be like a 5-2. Oh, so I quite like the idea of him just making a couple of guys, and then I can just play the Cult Master and draw a bunch of cards.
I am not a morning person.
It's time for a little blood.
Yeah, that's fine. I'm happy with that. I've got plus two cards out of it. As long as I don't do anything too stupid, or unless he's got a ridiculously powerful deck, of course. But I have the Consecrate Equality combo now. Definitely feeling it, to be honest. Actually, we don't need to. You know what? We actually...
Let me think.
We don't need to at all. It's like all my tricks, if I do
Let
that.
Me think.
Like, we could just run that in and just not care about these.
I must move quickly.
Who's next?
Squire, attend me.
Ready, sir.
There's no reason for me to waste an equality and a consecrate on just minions that I can just kill with my other crappy guys. You know, he's going to make something powerful, and then I want to be able to go, okay, yeah, I want to kill that. So again, same thing, if he just comes at me, we consecrate equality and then silence our own guy to put it back to 5-6. and I want him to sort of maybe throw out some more guys as well.
The Sunwell.
So now, because I've got a 5-7 he can't target, he has to put some big guys out. So my plan of going equality, consecrate, silence my 5-7 is probably fine. Definitely fine. He's just going to hate me so much. He's going to be so salty. But likewise, I mean, we could just silence this and not care, right? Well, you know, you've got a 2-power guy.
Let me think.
And again, Flame Strike doesn't kill it. So I've tried to throw out a few guys there which aren't affected by Flamestrike as much, you know, because he replaces himself and he's obviously huge and he was a free guy I drew. And I did want to get this Frostwolf Warlord like as big as possible, really. Well, obviously you flame strike, you've got one that doesn't even bear thinking about. It was a pretty easy decision. It's like skill strike, you know? It just means mages can just not care about what's in their deck because they have Flame Strike. But given he didn't fireball my 7-7 last turn or polymorph it, it says to me he doesn't have those cards. So I'm just going to make a War Golem. Oh, and look what he's just drawn. There we go. But it's not enough, unfortunately, and he's died.
Well played.
Oh, the ooze. He's been saving the ooze for a special occasion.
The sun well.
Oh, he's gonna be so mad.
For justice!
Your magic shall not save me.
Bash. He's saving the ooze the entire game. And I played my weapon on a turn I killed him. So that was a really interesting game, that wasn't it? Had to play around two flame strikes. And tried to bait him as much as I, and you know, definitely didn't shoot my load too early with the consecrate. I think that was pretty important. You know, sometimes in the back of your mind you just have to go, I've only got one board sweeper. I gotta be smart with how I use it.
The light shall bring victory.
I will fight with honor.
Now obviously Yeti's ridiculously good against Priest, but it's just too slow here. I can't really afford to keep it. So, yeah, not ideal. I've got the equality if he comes out to an absolute barnstorming start. To hopefully try and get me back into the game. But we are going first, so we're going to have that couple of turns to recover if we do have a terrible hand. It is the luxury you have of going first, is that your opponent has a really hard time of being able to crush you.
Greetings.
Well met. Reporting for duty.
My apologies.
The damned stand ready.
I mean, we could just equality here, to be honest. I actually quite like that, to be honest.
I don't have enough mana.
The light the shall burn.
You know, I mean, that's a really good card that I was going to have a lot of problems dealing with. And it lets me get the board position in the middle. And then hopefully, you know, stuff can happen, really.
Reporting for duty.
Not on my watch.
He's gonna hate my Dark Iron Dwarf, isn't he? You can just tell. So, if he's thinking of running that into that, he's obviously considering Holy Nova.
Squire, attend me!
Ready, sir.
So, bubble on the 4-4, beat up the 4-4. 2-3, beat up the 2-2. Well, that 2-2, I guess. Think.
Not on my watch.
Done.
So even though I don't gain any life, because that can become a 2-3, it could, you know, get a little bit problematic, right? If he Holy Novus, then he gets to clear the board here, so...
We must cleanse the Sunwell.
Quickly.
Actually, kinda wanna keep my Dark Iron Dwarf.
Dingo! Yes!
I considered the Fen Creeper. I was like, you know, but he might have another Shadow Word Pain, and it's like Shadow Word Pain versus Holy Nova. But a little bit of me was also thinking, would he have Holy Nova'd the previous turn? I kind of feel like previous turn Holy Nova's really good. You know, kill through my guys. So I'm possibly less likely to see one, given he didn't do it last turn. But he's definitely losing the center of the board here. And if he does have a Shadow Word Pain, he probably does it now on the zombie, right? But again, you know, I've been wrong in the past. Go! He was saving one. Couple of points short.
For justice,
the battle. Reporting for duty. The battle.
Yep, my bomber's still being crap. It's like he missed a lot of good guys on my side of the board. I'm hitting you for 10, 11.
Must consider.
Another. Oh, okay. Thank you very much. That was a mistake. Why would you do that? I gain the life now. You don't gain 5 life. Why did you Shadow Madness that? Oh, that's shockingly poor. Like, what are you doing? Shadow Madness my Harvest Golem. Run it in to my zombie, gain 5 life. His brain just exploded. And he pretty much made the worst possible move there. I think he realised that. He went Shadow Madness thinking he could kill the guy he pinched and he would still gain the 5 life. And then he went, oh no, you gain the 5 life, don't you? Yes, I'm an idiot. And then he healed the zombie back up, rather than healing himself to keep him alive as well. He was too busy spamming emotes to actually learn how to play the game properly there.
I will fight with honor.
I just keep this. Like, make zombie chow, put the blessing of wisdom on it, turn 2. Draw some cards. And he'll now go backstab your chow, coin, make weapon, hit chow to kill it, and I will cry. Very nice draw, that peacekeeper. Hopefully lets me carry on drawing cards. Now, a few things spring to mind here. One, that I want to keep the Peacekeeper because it's really good and I can get rid of something amazing. Two, if I put the Shattered Sun Cleric to buff up this, he still gets to deal it 4 damage with like an Eviscerate or a Backstab next turn.
We must cleanse the Sunwell.
So, it might be better just to Peacekeeper and turn this into a 1-3 and make it harder for him to be able to kill it, right? But this hand is just looking fantastic, to be honest. Drawn a bunch of cards, going first, and he doesn't have the board position yet. Make a huge guy he can't target. So he can't sap it, which is like really important. Even if he has Dark Iron Dwarf, he can't do anything with that either. And it seems also a really good target for an older Peacekeeper.
Follow the rule.
I mean, I screwed up there again because he's got Betrayal, so I should be putting the untargetable thing in the middle. Keep forgetting about that.
Your magic shall not see.
So he has 5 cards, I have 5 cards, and I have 3 guys on the board as well as that. It's like, do I want to run all my guys in? Or do I equality just to save one of them? And hit him for 4. Still maybe a little bit early for Hogger. But yeah, probably need some taunts, right?
Reporting for duty.
See whether he has that sap. He's desperate to target that guy. Well, he does get to target it with that. I let him off with that one. So now he has 3 sort of reasonably sized guys there. They all trade off with my guys. So I'm feeling the love for Hogger a little bit more here. We could just leave him with the Spectral Knight and make a Spiteful Smith or a War Golem or any of my big things. It's like, is it really need to equality here?
I wonder.
Must move quickly.
Yeah, we probably should. I feel maybe he saps the 3/6 or even assassinates it last turn. So I can maybe get away with the War Golem. Screwed here. So the plan is to run this into this Enrage, being able to deal 6 damage to the Blade Master.
For justice!
Make Hogger and go. Go? And hope he doesn't have a Deathwing. Or Skillwing. As we should all call him. And then we get to make a 10-10 Frostwolf Warlord next turn. Although I'm probably going to make him 9-9, right? And so I can make a Gnoll on the side. Because Gnolls are cool. We like Gnolls.
I am the Blade of the Gods.
Not gonna lie to you. Might not be what you want right now. Actually, we can make the Warlord 10-10.
Squire, attend me.
Ready, sir.
Guess we'll just kill him, right? Rather than making a 10-10 Frostwolf Warlord. Yeah, let's go. So the plan was, 6 guys out, make the Warlord 10-10, then you run your guy into his guy, kill him off, and then you make the Gnoll at the end of turn. But yeah, I just went, you know what, actually, you're just better. 8-0 on Bonfire Night as well. It's a pretty cool deck. Turns out Pallies are cool. Right? We like Pallies. I mean, this isn't a particularly powerful deck. 1 Consecrate, 1 True Silver Champion. I think the 2 Argent Protectors I'm happy about. Like, the double Zombie Chow as well are sort of really cute and nice.
Justice demands retribution.
We're going first, but I want none of these cards. So I will take a different 3 cards. And now we might be in trouble. Ciao! Fireworks still going off outside. So, that's either Avenge or Noble Sacrifice, but given he played it turn 1, it'll be Avenge. Like, you don't play a Noble Sacrifice turn 1 there, because he knows I can just make a 1-1 and run it in and trigger it. So, I really would expect that to be Avenge. So it just means I have to sort of keep the Peacekeeper in my hand.
Reporting for duty.
Die,
landlubber. Reporting
and
for duty.
Run my guy in when I want to kill his guy, and then Peacekeeper it after the Avenge triggers.
One shot, one.
Or I could just silence it afterwards. I mean, that would probably be fine as well, right?
Die, landlubber.
Ah!
Your magic shall not save me.
Yeah, making a guy he can't target with a Shattered Sun Cleric and Alder Peacekeeper in hand. That seems fine.
Let the pain speak to me.
Reporting for duty.
So I'm going to kill that just in case he's got a Blessing of Kings. Like, I don't want him having a 5-8. Although, I mean, sure, I can silence it. But I'm fine with him drawing one card. But I'd rather keep the silence for something devastating. And he's got the exact same combo I have. Okay. He might have a Blessing of Kings. So if he Blessing of Kings, he hits me for 11, which still feels fine. And then I just Peacekeeper him, or silence it.
We must cleanse the Sunwell.
So if he does have Blessing of Kings, I just want to take my Yeti out of 5-5 range. In other words, he turns this into a 5-5, now it's going to die when it runs into this. Whereas if it's a 4-5, he gets to hit it for 5 and then, like, attack me afterwards. Shock horror! It's a Blessing of Kings. So he should just run into my 3-2 and then into the 5-6 afterwards. Of course, he might go Noble Sacrifice and just go to my face, thinking that's going to work. Yeah, that'll be what he's hoping for. It's not going to work out for him. But, you know. It was a nice thought. Given he's played his Equality Consecrate combo, I think I can go ahead and play Hogger here. And he's also played a True Silver, so he needs either a second True Silver or a Consecrate. Both of which he's already played.
Let me think.
so now he's boned. Is the answer to that one?
Reporting for duty.
The Frost Wolf stands ready.
So given this is another Avenge, I'm going to turn this into a 3-3. So we probably beat that up afterwards. It's just basically saying you have to have a Consecrate and a Silence. And a true Silver Champion to kill Hogger. Or else you've lost. I mean, you could have another Equality Consecrate combo, but that would be quite frankly ridiculous.
Squire, attend me!
Ready, sir.
Seems pretty good.
We must cleanse the sun.
He just makes some irrelevant cards and then loses.
To battle!
Oh, turns out I'm not an idiot. Who would have guessed? There was a chance he was hoping I'd run my 9-7 into his noble sacrifice. So he had a really good deck. Just my deck was being really, really nice to me. And I think I went first, which again, super important. He's a druid, and he's also a role player. I'm going to keep the Shadow Sun Cleric, because I've got two zombie chows I want to see one of. And again, you know, like going chow, coin into Shadow Sun Cleric's really good. But this is probably my first loss, given I've got all these expensive cards in my hand. Mm-hmm, yep. Yep. Feeling like a loss, to be honest.
Reporting for duty.
As he's going to be making like a 4-4 when I have a 1-1. Luckily he doesn't have anything, but he's definitely going to be making a Druid of the Claw next turn. So he either has to have a really terrible hand, or I've lost.
I must safeguard the land.
Six mana to my four. Yeah. Don't see myself winning this one. Really don't.
Bring me steel.
Oh, unless you make more terrible cards.
We must cleanse the Sunwell.
That would be absolutely fine. That is acceptable for you to make really poor cards. You'll have no problems with that.
We must cleanse the Sunwell.
For justice!
So I'm thinking about both the Consecration and the Cult Master in my hand. That I quite like him to, you know, trade off or something there. Got a swipe.
Well played.
Yeah, of course. Well, okay, you got a wrath. Wrath's fine. I can live with wrath. Now I get to play Cult Master and draw two cards, right? Don't have anything to go with it, but, maybe Hogger?
Let me think.
Yeah, I can draw one card. One card's... Yeah, I'll draw two cards. No. Yeah, it doesn't help me, Cult Master, there. Maybe just lob the Fen Creeper down?
Let me think.
And let him chew it? I mean, I don't want to run my two guys in and consecrate. I really want to set up this Cult Master. Which I can do this turn, pretty much. Do we even throw Hogger away as an option? Like, I don't need Hogger at this point, but the 2/2s are really handy. But I kind of like to consecrate after the 2/2.
Let me think.
You know, run these two in. That dies. Run the 3/2. into the 2-2 he makes, and then, yeah, I guess we just throw Hogger away at this point. We don't need him.
I must move quickly.
Push forward.
Yeah, I'll just have 8 cards to your 1. Who needs Hogger? Hogger is surplus to requirements. Yeah, I'll have another card. Go. And I have yet another card off this cult master, right? Yes, I will. Oh, and unfortunately for him, he gets silenced.
Your magic shall not save me.
We must cleanse the Sunwell.
So yeah, this game played out totally differently to how I thought it would.
Silver Moon shall not fall.
And then I get to gain a bunch of life with this Guardian Skins.
Squire, attend me.
Ready, sir.
The Frost Wolves stand ready.
Duck, mage.
Push forward.
Okay.
So that just get his board clear so he can't deal me like 13 points of damage next turn. And then, you know, kill him.
Well played.
Well played.
14, 18, 20, 22, yeah.
To battle.
And then throw in a little bit of BM as well. Because I can. Just to show him I had the combo the entire game and didn't use it. Deck's actually turning out to be pretty ham. I'm going to take a screenshot of this deck. Ten and O. There is a turn up for the books. I think the double zombie chow is a huge bonus, and like all the cards have been really good. Blessing of Wisdom has been really good. Very few cards I'm unhappy with in this deck.
Uther,
but now I'm going Uther. To be coming up against other ridiculous decks,
I
right?
I will fight with honor. Justice demands retribution.
It's going to be a rough one going second. We need a zombie chow. Pretty sharpish.
Wanna blow something up?
And now I get the zombie chow. Like, damn it! So I put the Blessing of Wisdom on his guy in case he has Argent Protector. As at least that compensates me, you know, with the card. Like, do I really care about him drawing two cards? I could silence it, he could have no cards, but then, like, I'm just throwing my owl away, right? Nice draw. Save the Peacekeeper for something juicy. That's fine. You can have a 1/2.
That was a mistake.
So yeah, probably fine to go ahead and silence that since I've got nothing else we can do about that.
Pass me that artless banner.
And there is a good target for a Peacekeeper.
Cleanse the Sunwell.
Hey, give me a minute.
So I lose if he plays a Cult Master now, but it's pretty unavoidable. Like, there's no way of getting his board clear. And I wanted to not lose too much off a consecration. That brutalizes me as well completely. So, like, this game is pretty much over now. Like, I have no way of killing this 6/6 at any point.
Not on my watch.
So all he needs here is a weapon or a consecrate, and like it's just, or any heal. Way too much he can do here. And so he's just going to get card advantage from killing my guys and having bigger guys. Yep. I can't beat Sword of Justice, so we're going to let him have this one.
Well played. Victory.
He went first, therefore he won. It's that simple, and I got my first really bad draw of the day, so that's what happens. I'm just gonna shut the window because it's really cold now, and I think we've all heard enough of the fireworks. My gosh, is it cold? Let's get this headset back on there. So yeah, that was a fairly even game. Right up until the point he made the champion. I mean, you know, if I had consecrate equality, yeah, I'm still in the game. But I had neither of them. So therefore, it was well and truly over.
I will fight with honor.
This could be the second loss. Go on, let's have some guys I can play. No, that's not a guy I can play. Like, this is pretty much the worst 4-drop. With having nothing else out there. It's really uninspiring. I just have to hope my opponent has a really slow hand as well. And he does, lucky me. But what does that tell you, the fact that he attacked that? Swipe? Did it say he's got a swipe in his hand? I think that's what I read into it there. Well, certainly a wrath, if not a swipe. Or maybe the Keeper of the Grove is another one. He's thinking he's going to coin into Keeper of the Grove. Yeah. He absolutely has a swipe in his hand.
Someone called for it.
The battle!
Die, land lover!
So I'm just going to draw a card and let him swipe. Like, he can't not have that. I mean, he could have a swipe and a Keeper of the Grove.
Do you like to play with fire?
I think that also works. So I'll make a guy he can't target. As that makes him harder, a lot harder for him to cast spells. And if he does have a swipe, I'm going to play the Gnomish Inventor rather than like a Chillwind Yeti there. see how he feels about running both of his guys into my 4-6. It would certainly make sense for him to do that. I mean, he's not going to play a spell now, not after playing the Chillwind Yeti. Yeah, he just kills his own guy at that point, so that doesn't make any... Okay, that's probably the only spell you could play, but again, that's not achieved anything. Yeah, achieved nothing at all. Like, oh, okay, I get to do 8 damage and then nothing. All you can do is hit me for 8. That's all you can do now. Oh, okay, you've just killed your own guy. Well played. he didn't think that one through at all. So if he makes a huge guy, we've got the equality. If he doesn't make huge guys, we just beat him up and play some of our stuff. Yeah. We're just equalizing.
The battle!
Still, you know, he gets to swipe and clear the board, but, like, that's fine. He might also just make a tree, which also is cool for me, because I've got Argent Protector.
Not on my watch.
So throw a bunch of guys out there and hopefully try and protect this Blessing of Wisdom that'll draw me some cards. Instantly gets shot down.
Your magic shall not see.
There's not really a huge deal of point to what he's doing. Weapon on the 4-3? I feel like the Chow should run itself in there, to be honest. So yeah, you know, if you get the board position in the middle, he has to do something really stunning to get back into the game. Like playing Ironbox! But, you know, that's...
For justice!
That's what these little guys are for. And the next Ironbark he plays just gets silenced. And he's dead. Because I hit him for 16. Plus 2, 18.
Hmm.
to Northrend!
Good times. Hmm. 11-1. Here's the big one then. The big one to go 12-1. I don't mind if I finish up 11-3. I mean, I've got 11 wins. What do I care? No difference between 11 and 12. You get 30 more dust. Or you get a golden common. Congrats on your 12 wins.
Versus Valera.
Have a golden iron beak owl.
I will fight.
As it turns out, I'm not going 12-1. Not with this hand. And not with this hand anyway. So I'm now 12. I'm now 11-2 in this video. Like, this game is a write-off. We're going to ignore what happens in this game. I have to get very lucky now. He's kept one card, so he's probably a backstab. Yeah, I've just lost this one. You can fast forward 5 minutes to the next game. Nothing's going to be happening here. Because my opponent's obviously got a really powerful deck. And I have nothing! And he's probably thinking, I've got a really powerful deck because I'm playing Paladin. And he knows all the good Paladin cards. I'm making 1-1s, that's all I'm doing. On turn 3, I'm going to make a 3-2 with no abilities.
We must cleanse the sun well.
That's how I roll. If I'm really lucky, he coins into a Yeti here. And I get to Dark Iron Dwarf my 3-2 and kill it. That's if I'm lucky. If I'm unlucky, he coins and makes, like, SI7 agent, and I just cry at that point. Yeah, figured you'd have a backstab, something like that in your hand. And again, again, I'm just sat here with my Dark Iron Dwarf going, yep. This is pretty crap. I'm just throwing my guys away. Like, my mana curve starts at 5. But I should definitely make the Spectral Knight next turn, because, you know, because of sap and things like that. So I want to make something that has a chance.
The Frost Wolf stands ready.
He's probably thinking, this guy's just a clown. Like, what is he doing? I'm like, yeah, I have no idea what I'm doing either.
To Northrend! Victory!
I'm just sitting here being really poor at the game with my expensive deck of thoroughly average cards. So all I can do is make a 7-7 and hope he doesn't have a sap. Or a Shattered Sun Cleric. Or anything at all. Or an Eviscerate, because he gets to go deal it 4, run it in with a 2-1, hit your guy for 7 with my weapon.
I've got a heat.
Yep. My hand is terrible. I'm fine giving you this game. Like, let's not play this game any longer. It's very depressing. You know, I'm kind of glad that, you know, I got screwed over by my deck when I was at 11 wins rather than when I was at 1 win. Like, to go this far without getting a truly awful draw like that is cool with me. But, yeah, nothing I can do there. That just had loss from start to finish.
For Doomhammer,
I will fight with honor.
But we get to go first in the big one. Again, two cards I really don't want in my opening hand. Though the equality is very nice. Yeah, I want to see my Argent Protectors. I don't mind keeping Cult Master if I draw an Argent Protector. But then that builds up my board. Wow, yeah. That's nice now. Now I like my hand. So I did that just so I have guys for my Cult Master. We can draw two cards here, but then his guy still trades off afterwards. But I do get two cards, but my board position doesn't really help. And if I bubble up my guys, there's a risk. I get lightning stormed out the game. Maybe I just bubble up one this turn. Yeah, I don't wanna lose that second Argent Protector to a lightning storm just yet. If we can set up even a play at 6 mana where I have a bunch of guys and he has a bunch of guys and I get to go equality, Cult Master, draw a lot of cards and kill your board. Like, that's also fine. Because next turn I could just make like a Frostwolf Warlord as well as an option.
I wonder.
But I do need to draw at least two cards, I think, off this Cult Master. Doomhammer?
The Frost Wolves stand battle!
Fine. Works with me.
Get in there and fight, maggot.
You call that a win?
To battle.
Bit of depressing, really, but that's just the way it is.
What to do?
For the crusade!
Your magic shall not save
me. We must cleanse the Sunwell.
Let's try again with the Cult Master, as the army of fire elementals comes down.
Reporting for duty.
Not really ideal. I'm going to hold back on the Grizzly, because I want to play it on the same turn as the Cult Master, really, there. And I want him to throw a few guys out. For the equality.
Pass me that arc-like spanner.
That seems a nice draw.
Reporting for duty.
So I can equality and just make my weapon to kill his biggest guy if he does have that. And go like Grizzly Cult Master. Like, I think I can take this pretty slow this game at the moment. I'm still at 30 life and I think I can make the card advantage. Get a consecrate.
Reporting for duty. For justice.
Not seen any fire elementals out of him. Really wouldn't surprise me.
Shall not fall.
Hmm. Augur seems a pretty good pull. He can still kill it, unfortunately, with these two. So I'll save it for next turn. He might also be sandbagging a hex. Or sandbagging a flame tongue totem. So, yep. Looking like being game, that flame tongue totem, right? I mean, he's still fine here if he runs his 5-3 into my Hogger. Which he did, so that's nice. But, you know, he's made a taunt totem, so what does he care, right? Yeah, but he would have turned this into like a 3-2, which would have been a much better thing for him to do, and still have his 4-3 or whatever on the other side. Consecrate. Consecrate? Consecrate? Not a consecrate.
Justice. Reporting for duty.
The battle!
So we just sit here and throwing the card we draw every turn into play and see what happens. My complete inability to deal with the flame tongue totem. And that's game. Yep, that is actually game. Did you just screw up? Why did you do that? Oh, of course, you've got another spell. Yeah, of course. How silly of me. How silly of me. Consecrates? Still no consecrates.
The battle! The battle!
So, no silence, and because I've still got an owl in my deck, I think.
Shields up!
Yeah, obviously. Why are you not attacking me? Attack me for 13! What are you doing? Just attack me for 13, and you win. How lucky! The first good top deck I've had.
Victory! The battle! The battle! The battle! Reporting for duty.
It's hard work, isn't it? Trying to kill a flame tongue totem. As he just goes, oh! Oh, and finally he makes, yeah, another fire elemental. Finally he makes the 1-1 totem that I've been waiting for the entire game, so he can't heal. Consecrate? Consecrate? Finally, the totem dies. After too many turns of pain. I draw my consecrate, and it's like, yeah, obviously, right at the bottom of the deck. Yeah, and this is why he's had tons of wins. Dear. Absolutely fantastic, isn't it? It's like, yeah, I just have fire elementals, that's all I have. Make another fire elemental, make another fire elemental. You gonna kill me? We don't have. Oh, you are gonna kill me. I was wondering when you were going to do that. So, shame we didn't get to 12 wins. Not really surprising against that last deck, but a couple of really rubbish, crappy draws at the end there. Like, never doing anything against that rogue. Hand is 6 mana, 5 mana, 5 mana, ditch it, 5 mana, 5 mana. Yeah. Ooh, a golden head crack. Anyway, guys, thanks for checking this video out. It's been a very long video, so yeah, I'm pretty certain you all wised up to how many wins I was going to end up with, roughly. More uninspiring things out of the booster. And don't forget to, you know, join us over at Facebook and stuff like that, and click the like and leave a comment and tell me how terribly I played, as everyone always does, and see you next time. Ta-da.